It's live too. Just for you. If you love losing on live. Last time he said that he lost. Last time I checked, you was on for a minute. Miss me with that, put that, I'll be back in a minute. With my good vibes, good vibes, man, I like good signs and good. Just got my recline and I'm watching pizza on the Wi-Fi. I cannot just go away. Can you bring me back to my old ways? Tell my mom and dad I'm playing for some better days. Only good vibes Friday to Friday. I'm looking for a highway.
Night beginning to fall over Southern California, but the lights are shining bright here at the spectacular SoFi Stadium in metropolitan Los Angeles. Straight ahead, it's a matchup of unbeatens between the Las Vegas Raiders and the Los Angeles Chargers. Set to go now in week 6 of the NFL season, and we are
you see how locked in you are?
EA Sports.
This about is taking just dream.
Shy of the 10. And they're going to start this drive in pretty good shape up past the 30.
So locked in, man. They're in the depth chart, too. Don't leave it.
You need a drip? I bet his name on YouTube, George Pearson.
He really don't want to watch it lose. He really don't want to watch you lose. Right. You be wasting game time. Yeah, shut the fuck up. Good idea.
I'm waiting for you. You try to hold niggas up.
Game ain't even start yet. You have zero momentum. Come on, dude. I think they got that when you're home.
Line of scrimmage, the 31 now on first and 10. This is the Oklahoma State alum, Chris Carson. And he'll hope that this is not a sign of what's in store as he has to fight just to get back to the line of scrimmage. Call it no gain on the game's first play. And it's second down now. Shotgun, it's Prescott escaping the pressure right. Caught by the tight end Ertz. And he'll be upended at the 33 following a gain of 3. And guess what? It brings up third down. Well, this defense for the Raiders, they played really well in that win last week against Miami.
And no matter what's done throughout a ball game, it always comes back to blocking and tackling. That's the essence of football. But I think it's hard for people to understand just how difficult it is to tackle, especially open field. Very few missed tackles on tape that I saw last game. This team does a nice job of getting their opponents on the ground.
Now a shot taken on third down, but it's going to wind up incomplete.
An early message that this secondary is going to be tested because even though it fell incomplete, it almost felt like a warning shot to get things going.
On fourth down, here's Sam Martin on to kick it away. Back deep is Tyreek Hill. He was only asked to punt once in the victory last week as he sends this one away. And this will be down by a member of the kicking team just outside of the 30-yard line. They'll try and start this drive in the air. Flushed out right. Oh, he's going to take a shot right away. And that's caught inside the 35. A big play there for the Raiders. So the big play changes the complexion of things. Here's first and 10 just outside the 30. He'll look to throw. Pitch and catch here to Travis Kelce. And he'll go down at the 26 following a gain of 6.
Brandon, a perfect defense in this situation would have meant that there was an incompletion. They would have picked it off. Okay, so they gave up the completion. But I really enjoyed watching how the defense stayed in sync, stayed in great communication. And as he dragged across each zone, you see him pointing, communicating. There he is, and they passed him off to each defender. Ended up making a nice play, even though it was complete.
Eluding the pressure right. This pass going to be caught by Hardman. And he gets it inside the 10 to the 9. So first and goal from the 9-yard line. They'll stick with the passing game as he looks to throw. And this is going to be intercepted. Picked up by Minkah Fitzpatrick. And the Chargers are going to get the football here as the ball will come out to the 20. The Charger drive about to get going.
And this ball game, clearly the game of the year so far. It's not very often that you find two unbeaten teams playing each other this late in the season, but that's what we have here, two heavyweights in the NFL.
You're right about that, and you think about recent memories, so let's take a little ginkgo right now and go down memory lane, right? 2007, 7-0 Colts, 8-0 Patriots. The Pats won 24-20, they end up going 16-0. And
he rifles one that's intercepted. Picked off at the 22. And they're going to take over right there at the 22-yard line. Trying to shake off the interception from the last drive. He'll look to throw. And he'll protect himself at the end here as he winds up getting pretty decent yardage. The play fake. He'll look to throw. And going deep for Hill. A fight for the football, and it's intercepted. Picked up by Minkah Fitzpatrick. And the Chargers are going to take possession here at their own 16-yard line. The Charger drive about to get going. They'll start out on the ground with Carson. And he'll lose yardage on this one, back to the 13. A 3-yard loss to start the drive. They'll look to make that up and then some on second and 13. They'll roll it, and he's going to go down. Back at his own 5-yard line, it's a sack. Trey Hendrickson. It'll go as a loss of about 8 as he gets in there to drop him. After the sack, they'll come up now 3rd and long.
Yeah, I wouldn't be surprised to see them run the ball here just to try and get some space.
And he will not be able to hang on through the contact. It's incomplete. The coverage strong, and now it's 4th down.
This offense has definitely been slow getting out of the gate. It's almost like they missed their wake-up call for this one. No points on their first two possessions, and now it's looking like none on this one either.
And now this is either a fake or their coach is delusional or both here. Now hold everything here. We're going to get a timeout by the offense. They'll have 2 remaining as we step aside here in this first quarter. Here's Sam Martin now as the drive goes backwards, so he's on to punt it away. And he'll just punch it out of there, and it's not a great kick.
Now Hill to return it.
A very nice job on the run back there. He'll get 23 yards all told. And this offense set up with a very short field. First and 10 inside the 20. They go back to the air here after the INT on the last drive. Flush to his right.
Looks to me, partner, like he's learned a little bit, because earlier in the game, I think he was trying to force a lot of throws into his windows that just weren't open.
Yeah, the interceptions had plagued him, especially a second interception. And he's in! Touchdown, Raiders! It's their quarterback, his 19th touchdown now of the season. And the Raiders on just two plays have taken the lead. They'll drop to throw. Dancing to his left. To the goal line, but it's incomplete.
I don't know about you, but I can't wait for a few years of two-point tries and see what the data tells us, because a lot of teams want to throw the ball in this situation, this time unsuccessfully. I just wonder if maybe running the ball might be the way to go.
With it moved up from the 3 to the 2, you would think maybe a few more attempts at running.
I think stats over time may bear out that running the ball will at least be the equal of throwing it in that situation.
The Charger drive about to get going. They've shown precious little here offensively thus far as they try again with a first down now. And not too much going there as he'll get it up to the 23-yard line. The run only got a yard. Here's 2nd and 9. On play action, Prescott steps away. Open here, Adam Thielen. And he's taken down, but able to slip across the 35. Line of scrimmage, the 37 on 1st and 10.
We talk about mobility on quarterbacks all the time. Here's where it really pays off. Able to move, evade, and is accurate throwing on the run and picking up a first down.
2 yards the loss, 2nd and 12. 6-0 our score after one. So the first down run lost a couple. Now they come up 2nd and 12. To throw is Prescott. Going for Metcalf on the deep ball. That's caught inside the 20. And he'll get this all the way down inside the Vegas 20. A big play there for L.A. On first down, it's Carson. And he'll get it here to the 10-yard line. It's a 6-yard gain on the ground, and that'll make it 2nd and 4. Prescott now. Forced out to his left. He'll be hit as he releases it, and that'll fall incomplete.
Certainly appeared to take away his first read, and by the time he tried to look elsewhere and find an open target, the coverage was too good. That one falls incomplete.
Escaping the pressure right. He's got his man. It's caught. Touchdown, Chargers. Jerry Jeudy. His 2nd touchdown on the season. And the Chargers are an extra point away from moving out in front. Tucker able to connect on the extra point. They take the lead here at 7-6. Tucker now to kick it away following the touchdown. Tyreek Hill on the return. And able to get this out to the 25. The Raider offense set to get this drive started. And they are trying to create some separation within the division. And look, CD, I know that this is still the first half of the season, but this is a big matchup no matter where it falls, because these are the top two teams right now in that. And for the 3rd time here in this half, it's intercepted. Picked off by Stephon Gilmore. And the Chargers are going to have the short field here as they'll take over right at the 50. So they try to take the deep shot there, but this defense up to the task.
And a lot of times when you air a ball out like this, if it does get intercepted, there's going to be a lot of space out there to set up a return. And remember, you've got 5 big offensive linemen out there playing on their feet in open space. Not a skill most of them possess that allows for extra yardage on the return.
They've got good starting field position as they come up here 1st and 10, right at the 50-yard line. Following the interception, here's Prescott. Flushed out right. On the run, he'll let this go deep right side. And that is incomplete. So this game of ours, Charles, you know, the talk of the NFL world all week, two unbeaten teams. You rarely see such a matchup this deep into a season.
I would agree with that because normally you might get one team undefeated for a while, but two teams like this, and I remember in preseason, you looked at schedules and said, I think these two are on a collision course. It'd be interesting to see if they actually get there, and they did. And to me, the winner of this game has to wear the crown of Super Bowl favorite.
They have to like what they've done defensively here at the outset of this drive. They forced a couple of incomplete passes, bring up a third and 10. Don't be surprised to bring a little pressure on this snap.
Prescott now from the 50. Going for Metcalf on the deep ball. And unable to connect, incomplete. I'll give them credit, they took their shot, but it's gonna bring up fourth down.
And I think they'd be well served to take that type of a physical approach against him the rest of the game. He's had his way so far, but on that last one, that worked quite well for the defense.
Here's Sam Martin now. He'll boot it away from about his 35. He's been a busy man here in this first half as he gets it away. And that one hits at the 7, but bounds into the end zone, and that'll be a touchback. The Raider offense set to get this drive started. And last time, one play, interception. So this offense, they should be fresh.
That's a good way of putting it. And I can't wait to see what they decide to do with play calling, because a one-play drive where you throw an interception, a lot of people.
And this is caught right along the sideline. What a job of keeping the toes inbounds there. A big play there for the Raiders. So the big play gets them across midfield now for first and 10. Here's a play fake as they set up to throw. He's going to let this go. Back of the end zone. Toward the back corner of the end zone, but he could not get the feet down. This will wind up incomplete. After the incomplete pass, here now is second and 10. On play action, they'll throw. Taking a deep shot here for Hardman. And oh, it'll be intercepted. Picked up by Jalen Ramsey. And the Chargers are going to take possession here at their own 16-yard line. Well, we heard all week that they were going to put the football in the air a lot. The problem is that is now 4 interceptions, Charles, that he has thrown in this first half. How do you treat a situation? What do you say to your quarterback right now?
Boy, that's an interesting question because a lot of it depends on the head coach and the people making the decisions. You have to know your quarterback and know if he's mentally tough enough to have a chance to turn it around. Or is he a guy that maybe you've seen enough and it's time to go to the backup? But right now what you're rooting for is your defense to help keep you in the game, to give him an opportunity to get back on track.
Incomplete. Throwing the football, he's not as sharp as he was last week when he was over 70%. Right now, he's under 50%.
Well, that comes from extra game film, extra time. You know those guys watched him all week, saw how precise he was, and constructed a defense to try and chip away at that, and thus far they've been successful.
Into a sea of defenders and intercepted. Picked off by the Honey Badger, Tyrann Mathieu. And they have the football and will set up shop at the 33-yard line. You don't see this often, a quarterback of his caliber, 2 first-half interceptions.
It's absolutely surprising because it happens so rarely. You're searching for what reason, what's going on out there. It's not just maybe the defense is playing well. Is his horoscope off? His biorhythms? What is it?
You went horoscope on us, David.
Well, I was thinking maybe REM sleep was off. I'm trying to come up with something.
Anything, right? And it'll be incomplete. Good job staying with him defensively. And it'll bring up second down. The play action fake. They'll look to throw. Looking for Hill again. This time it's complete. And he will score. Touchdown, Las Vegas. Tyreek Hill, his 5th touchdown now on the year. And once again, the Raiders are back out in front. Extra point by Butker is on target. And that'll make this a 6-point game. Thank you.
Now after the touchdown, here's Butker on to kick it away. He will return this from deep in the end zone. And the decision to bring it out, not a good one, as he's tackled at the 15. The Charger drive about to get going. And following the interception, just any interception, are you a little bit more cautious when you start that next drive, or no, you just throw that out the window?
I think you are. I don't think that there's any way you can run back out there and go, totally didn't affect me. Let's just go ahead and be loose with the football again. You're going to take care of it, but you have to be careful about being too cautious, because now you can't run any offense at all.
Still want to. And down he goes, brought down, a Raider sack. It looks like a loss of right around 11 there on first down to set him back on second. Second and 21, a lot of ground to cover. Another try after the first down sack. Prescott going for Metcalf on the deep ball. And Prescott, his third interception. Picked off at the 28. And they're going to set up shop at the 27-yard line. Coming up in a couple of minutes, we'll get you to Jonathan Coachman in Orlando. The coach will have stats and scores from earlier today in the NFL. They'll come out throwing here to start the drive. Completes it to Hardman. And they get him down, but not before he takes it across the 40-yard line. They'll look to throw here on first down. And this will be incomplete. Physical play on the football there, and it's second down. An incomplete pass on first down. That leads to a second and 10. They're going to look to throw. Looking left side, and he's got a man. That's Hill. And he is out of bounds inside the 35. So they'll come up first and 10 now from the 33. Back to throw. Eluding the pressure right. Finding room to the 20. And he'll take it into the end zone for a Raider touchdown. Their mobile, agile quarterback with his second touchdown here in this first half. And the Raiders able to extend that advantage. Now the Raider offense will stay out there as they'll line up to go for two. They'll try and throw for it. Flush to his right. Looking end zone, but it's incomplete. So unable to throw it in for two from the two. Let me ask you, as a former DB, what changes there around the goal line on a two-point conversion as far as how you're defending it?
You just make sure you never back up and you never retreat. You establish yourself really on the line of scrimmage, put your heels on the goal line at worst, and if they're going to throw the ball, make them throw it over your head, because they're going to run out of space because of the back of the end zone. Never let a guy catch one in front of you.
And he'll just take a seat, and the drive will begin at the 25-yard line. The Charger drive about to get going. It was still more than a minute to go in the half. Time to try to mount a drive.
And I would think that they would have to. This is today's NFL. You got to push it whenever you get an opportunity. You can never have enough points with the high-powered offenses that you face. And analytics will tell you, try and score when given the opportunity.
They will get 4 yards here on the first down run, and that'll make it second and 6. Thank you. From the 45 on second down, Prescott escaping the pressure right. And he'll find Thielen on the right side. Touchdown! Adam Thielen, his third touchdown now on the year. And the Chargers get a late score here in the final minute of the first half.
I think everyone in the league talks about finishing, don't they? Doesn't matter whether it's a quarter, a half, a game, a series, whatever. But they're finishing the first half in fine style, putting that one in the end zone.
They did, and they didn't leave much time on the clock either. Well done. Prescott, they're going to throw for it. And for the fourth time tonight, it's an interception. Picked off by the Pro Bowler, Marcus Peters. And the Chargers are going to have the football here at their own 35-yard line. Tucker now to kick it away following the touchdown. Here's the dangerous Tyreek Hill. And he's only going to make it to the 13-yard line and no further.
For most people, the excitement of the kickoff return is to see a long one that goes back in the opposite direction. But for the guys covering it, it's being able to stop them deep in their own territory. How about that incredible form tackle right there? Shoulder into ball carrier, and down he goes.
The Raider offense set to get this drive started as they take over with just 17 seconds left before the break. And good yardage as he gets this one up to about the 23. Now the Raiders going to go ahead and use the second of their timeouts as they'll stop it with 13 seconds to play in half number one. Second and one. On the move, and he can't find anywhere to go with it, and he goes down. Now here's a timeout as they're going to get it with 8 seconds remaining here in the first half. On third and short, they'll try and pick it up through the air. Flushed out right. On the run, he'll let this go deep right side. And that will be incomplete. Well, they weren't scared to let it fly, but it falls to the ground and brings up fourth down.
I know he was trying to get the completion downfield, but the way this game has gone, with a few of the runs he's made along the way, he should have kept the ball and taken it with his feet downfield. That's the big play that shreds a defense. Instead, he thought to himself, I'm a quarterback, I've got to throw it. He bailed out the defense with that incompletion.
Now on fourth down, they throw the deep ball, but it winds up to be incomplete. All right, Coach, thanks. Yeah, both teams likely to make some changes in what's been a closely fought battle to this point. And how about this right out of the locker room, an onside kick attempt. The Raiders with the lead already, and they will get the football here as the second half is now underway. A very interesting call and one that backfires. I know they're losing, Charles, but boy, to start the second half with the onside kick, risky.
Felt like a sense of urgency from their side, coupled with, you and I both know the special teams coordinators, they sell their key plays each and every week to the head coach, don't they? And I'll guarantee he's been selling this one. We can get it, Coach, we can get it. And that came together with that sense of urgency you talked about.
5 yards on the carry, good pickup on first down. They'll keep it on the ground. Goodrich, and he gets it down to the 32. From the 32 now, here's first and 10. Looking to throw. That's out to Hill, right side complete. And he doesn't quite make it, taking it with it an eyelash. Dropped at the one. Back to throw here. And that's going to be caught for a Raider touchdown. Mecole Hardman.
his fifth touchdown now on the year. And the Raiders add on to their lead. The touchdown all set up by the big play one snap before, but they finish it off here with a shorter completion, this time for the score.
I like how they stuck with what got them there, right? The big pass play. Got the momentum going, right? That's, you create it with a play like that, and you come right back with another pass play to finalize things off.
And he will get into the end zone to extend the lead by two more. After the touchdown, here's Butker on to kick it away. And from deep in the end zone, he's going to bring this out. And ultimately cannot get this out to the 25-yard line as he's dropped at the 23. The Charger drive about to get going. I guess they have to feel a little gratified to at least get on the board last time, but still work to do.
No doubt about it. I wonder now if they're going to try to increase the urgency a little bit, maybe pump.
And this is, oh my goodness, he pulled it in one-handed. So that changes things in a big way. Now from all the way down inside the 30, here's first and 10. On the handoff, Stevenson. And only a yard this time as he's taken down right around the 26. Here's second and 9, just a yard on that last run. Play action now, Prescott rolling to his right. Going to throw deep for the end zone. And this is caught. He's got a touchdown, L.A. Zach Ertz, his fourth touchdown on the year. And the Chargers are able to make this a close game again. Now whistles and a timeout signaled here by the offense, and that's their first of this second half. Tucker now to add the point after. And that'll cut the lead down now to a touchdown. Tucker now to kick it away following the touchdown. And Hill will opt for the touchback. The Raider offense set to get this drive started. And their lead cut in half by that touchdown a moment ago. They are up 7. As they begin this drive, first and 10. Now a give, right side, Goodrich. And he'll wind up with about 6, up past the 30 to the 31. 6 yards on that last play, here's second and 4. They'll set up a throw. And going deep for Hill. And that gonna be incomplete. Good effort there, trying to take a shot, but it's third down.
Well, you most certainly don't want to go 3 and out here and get the football right back because your friend, Old Momentum, he's wondering if he should change sidelines about right now. And if you don't convert here, guess what? He's going to make the trek to the opposite side, and all of a sudden, you've got a battle on your hands.
And he'll take this to the other side of midfield before going out of bounds.
Now, that definitely hurts because the mindset is getting a 3 and out there, and they don't get it done. They give up the scramble and a pickup for a first down.
They'll run on first down. Goodrich. And he works free. The 20. And oh, so close as he takes it all the way to the 2-yard line. They'll try and run for it on first and goal. And that'll hurt the average a bit as this time they're able to get him behind the line. Call it a full 3 yards in the wrong direction there. Brings up second down. And this is going to be intercepted. picked off by Jalen Ramsey. And the Chargers are going to take over at their own 30-yard line. The interception woes, they just continue to mount. He's thrown five picks. At this point, you got to be thinking, is it something between the ears?
I think a confidence hit does occur once you start getting those numbers up there a little bit. But as you and I both know, it's not always just one guy's fault. Maybe somebody ran a wrong pattern. Maybe some balls were tipped. It could be so many different things. Bottom line, though, it comes back to the guy throwing it.
Third quarter of a tight football game as we come up on a second and 10. Prescott to throw it. This will be caught. Judy. And they bring him to the ground just shy of midfield. On first down. Carson, and he's able to get this one down to the 40-yard line. So here's a first and 10 now in Raider territory, right at the 40. Here's Prescott, sliding out of the pocket. And that is incomplete. He couldn't hold on through the contact. Brings up second down.
He did a fine job there of not hitting him before the ball arrived, and I've got to tell you, you can often mistime that play because of the angles of approach. When you're going to get him, sometimes you panic as well and think, I've got to be there right now. Instead, in this case, timed it perfectly and knocked it free.
And that'll fall incomplete. He was hit just as he let that go. And now it's third down. What a difference a week makes. Last week he hit on over 80% of his passes. This week he's down under 50%. What do you see as the difference?
Well, I think we're used to seeing a drop. If someone's over 80%, they're not going to hold that number, not in this league. But a drop under 50%, that just tells me that the defense has spent a lot of extra time.
And for the fourth time tonight, it's an interception. It's the Honey Badger, Tyrann Mathieu. And the Raiders will take over possession here up at the 44. Well, he went on the move there and started rolling out. I thought there was a window, but that window closed quickly, intercepted.
And sometimes, despite how big your arm talent is, you don't get enough on a throw when you're on the move as opposed to setting your feet and stepping into one. That may have been the case there, and the defense certainly benefited.
Third quarter now from SoFi Stadium. Here's a second and 10. Now back to throw. And now here is another interception. Picked up by Minkah Fitzpatrick. And the Chargers are going to get this back to their own 34-yard line. The Charger drive about to get going. Here's a handoff to Carson to begin the drive. Oh, look at the juke. And he'll rumble for about five, up close to the 40. After the pickup of five, here's second and five. Off the play fake, Prescott. He'll buy some time right. Now on the run, he'll throw it back deep over the middle. This is caught inside the 15. And he will finally be taken down. But how about that play? It's a big one. On the final act of the third quarter. From the 13 now, they work on first and 10. They'll toss it out to Carson. And he'll get this one down to about the 10-yard line. They're looking at a second and 8 now from the 10. Prescott off play action. They'll roll him out right. And that's going to be knocked away in the end zone. It's incomplete. Another throw there off the mark, and obviously he's battled all of the interceptions. Things just haven't been true to form for him. I don't know. What do you think's going on out there, CD?
That's a great question, and my suspicion is he's been coached really well to not show that he's having a problem. You know, they always tell you, no matter what, you keep throwing the football with confidence. Well, we're not seeing a confident thrower right now. He's off balance, the passing game's off balance, and the defense is taking advantage.
So on fourth down, out trots the kicker in a big spot here. And this one is no good. He missed it. And this score will stay right where it is. And that one, my goodness, that was almost too easy.
Yeah, you're not going to have too many attempts shorter than that one. And I don't think this was blocked. That's about as bad a miss as you can have.
And he will lose yardage on the play. Back at his own 19-yard line. A loss of a yard there to start out. That leads to a second and 11. Rolling to his right. Looking downfield for Kelce. And this will be caught at the 30. And he will score. Touchdown, Las Vegas. Travis Kelce, 81 yards.
And the Raiders add on to their lead, and it's looking like that win streak is going to extend another week.
Butker now to add the extra point. And the lead is up to 14. Now after the touchdown, here's Butker on to kick it away.
Now this will be returned from deep in the end zone. And the decision to come out of the end zone is going to cost him 5 yards as he's taken down right at the 20.
The Charger drive about to get going. And they have to feel like they missed on an opportunity for points last time when they couldn't connect on that short field goal try.
And no doubt about it, because
in trouble here, and down he goes. Back at the 8-yard line. Now then, after the sack, it'll be interesting to see what they have planned for second and 23.
Oh, he'll air this one deep for Judy.
And that will be incomplete. Tried to dial up the long way out there, but it'll be third down.
This defense is continuing to contest every deep ball that is thrown downfield. And look, it doesn't matter whether you're playing man or zone. Eventually, that becomes man on man. And you've got to trust yourself and go up at that moment of truth and make a play on the football.
The Chargers on third down. It's been a problem. Just 1 for 7 thus far. This will be third and a mile. Play fake. Here's Prescott.
Oh, he'll air this one deep for Judy.
And my goodness, another interception. Picked off at the 46.
With the points that we've seen scored, neither defense has been at their best, but these guys, they've been a little bit better, Charles, and a nice interception there.
Yeah, you're right about that, Brandon. Let's face it. It's not always how you start, it's how you finish, right? So maybe you have a rough game all the way along. If you make a big play like that at the right time, it can make everything turn out just okay.
And he'll go down, but not before getting this inside the 30. Now a play fake here on first down. Sliding out of the pocket. He's going to let it go deep for the end zone. Caught! It's the tight end, Kelce, for a Raider touchdown. Travis Kelce, his second touchdown of the night.
And the Raiders look like they're going to be moving to 6-0 as they extend that. Lead even further.
Butker on for the PAT. And the lead now to 3 touchdowns and 21 points. Now after the touchdown, here's Butker on to kick it away.
He will return this from deep in the end zone. And he'll be brought down shy of the 20, so the decision to bring it out of the end zone, not a good one.
The Charger drive about to get going.
That 5-game win streak is ticking away here in the fourth quarter. Just haven't been as sharp in this one.
Trying to shake off the interception. He'll look to throw. He'll buy some time right. Going for Metcalf on the deep ball. And incomplete on the deep ball.
Well, this has not been going the way that he thought prior to the game. Probably figured he'd be able to throw a few more downfield, but he's having to run around for his life back there. They've already gotten to him a number of times. They'll keep coming after him in the pass rush. My advice? Shorter passes. Get the ball out of your hand.
Yeah, he's just throwing the ball up for grabs now. Fortunately, that one gonna fall incomplete. The Chargers on third down. Just one conversion and eight tries. Not good. This is third and 10. They'll roll him out right. And that is incomplete.
That incompletion is not a surprise with the way that this one has gone, and the frustration, the body language is evident everywhere. This team, they've really been put through the ringer in this one.
So they're forced to punt on fourth as this one's away. 35 yards that time on the punt, and the Raiders will take over now first and 10. The Raider offense set to get this drive started as they try to finish things off in this fourth quarter, and that current five-game win streak looking like it's going to go to six. Now a throw right side, take it in here to start this drive. And he is out of bounds, but not before he's inside the 30. So from Charger territory now, here's a first and 10 at the 26-yard line. That's going to be caught, and he is in. Touchdown, Raiders. Tyreek Hill with his second TD of the game, his sixth on the year. And the Raiders are able to strike quickly to add on to their lead. They'll look to throw. And this is going to be caught. So add two more to the lead as they continue to pour it on here in the fourth. Now the Chargers will use the second of their timeouts. That's going to leave them with just one remaining here in this fourth quarter. Now after the touchdown, here's Butker on to kick it away. And from deep in the end zone, he's going to bring this out. And he will be brought down here inside the 20. Good coverage as he's dropped at the 17. The Charger drive about to get going. These guys had to punt their last possession, and that's become too familiar of a refrain. Too many of these drives just wound up going nowhere.
But you know how in baseball, when the pitcher gets a base hit and he's on base, they bring his jacket out to him to keep him warm? A lot of times the punter goes to the sideline and puts on sweatpants or a wrap over his leg to keep it warm. He might need a massage from the trainer right now from all the work he's getting.
And that's going to be incomplete. Good effort there, trying to take a shot, but it's third down.
As a former defender, I can feel their sigh of relief after that one, because when he breaks out of the pocket and you face a mobile quarterback, he causes all kind of problems in your secondary. They were able to force that incompletion.
On third down, it's Prescott. Rolling to his left. Oh, he'll air this one deep for Judy. And unable to connect. Incomplete. I'll give them credit. They took their shot, but it's going to bring up fourth down.
That one brought back a few nightmares, because when a quarterback gets outside of the pocket, your job as a defensive back, make sure you stay as deep as the deepest receiver and not let anyone leak behind you for a big play. A nice job there having discipline and not letting them connect on that pass.
Good block here, nearly sprung him. As it is, it'll go as a 19-yard return. And the offense will take over with a new set of downs. The Raider offense set to get this drive started. We've got a lopsided game here. I don't know, Charles, what does the handbook say that we discuss when we've got a game like this in the fourth quarter?
Hold a second. Let me thumb to the proper page on that. Know what it says?
What?
Let's discuss how we got here. This is a dominant performance, where they took control of this game, how they managed to keep control of this game, and then we go ahead and think about how we're going to leave here and get to the airport. In a lopsided blowout, the roads are usually open.
Now on first down, he'll drop to throw it. And that one drops down, incomplete. Good coverage there, forced the ball free, and it's second down. Now it looks like he'll throw here. And now here is another interception.
picked off by the linebacker, Demario Davis. And the Chargers will take over here at their own 12-yard line.
Charles, whatever's going on between his ears right now, it's just not completely calculated correctly. 7 picks between last week and this week after that one.
And they always say the most...
Pressure gets to him, and down he goes. Back at the 4-yard line.
Pass protection has been a problem all night long as they come up facing second and a bundle.
Yeah, he's just throwing the ball up for grabs now. Fortunately, that one going to fall incomplete.
This has been a rough one, to put it mildly, for him. And after this one's done, you just feel like at the post-game press conference, this team's going to have a lot of questions and definitely not a lot of answers.
Here now the punter, Martin, booming this one away. So possession goes over here on the punt. And the Raiders will have a short field to work with as they take over. They'll come out throwing here on first down.
And he's got the hook up to Ruggs.
And he's got this down a yard or two shy of the 40 before he's out of bounds. 3 yards the gain there, second down. He'll drop to throw. Throw left side complete. That's Rhodes. And they'll wind up getting this one all the way down inside the 20.
Well, partner, nothing but praise for me for this offense. They have been tremendous all night long. They knew what they had to do to unlock the defense. And let's face it, this has been a master class in offensive football that we've been here to witness.
First and 10, and they've got 3 tight ends out there. A jumbo package look. They'll look to throw here. Rolling to his right. And give him another 6. It's caught for a touchdown, and the blowout continues. And for them, this train, it just keeps rolling, doesn't it? Well on their way to yet another victory.
Yeah, it's almost a runaway, isn't it? And you just wonder how anyone could stop this. They got full momentum going, full confidence going. But it's not just their own confidence that is leading them. It's the lack of confidence against their opponents now, because they see them coming and think, we've got no shot to beat this team.
Extra point by Butker is on target, and the lead will swell by 1 more. Now after the touchdown, here's Butker on to kick it away. A fairly short kick from the 14. And they're going to start this drive in pretty good shape as they get it up past the 30.
shall come forth as pure gold. Have you been tried in the fire? Have you been tried in the fire? Well, tell me, did you come through as pure gold?
You kick it like the benefactor's benefactor. Well, truthfully, we know you never been a factor. Well, honestly, the truth is that you've been an actor. And now your actions got them boys about to mass up. Lectures from the devil got you piping hot. This up and you get screwed and chopped, no Michael Watts. When I was 10, I knew I should have been on rap a lot. Think like Jay Prince and I do more than just rap a lot. I went and got my digits up. Your favorite, bruh. You don't want no trouble, cuz the 25th I got a meeting with the governor. That's real rap a lot, no cap a lot. I used to from Farron down to Camelot. I used to whip up in my granny's pot. She asked my friends, was I? They said, nope, he not. The mind to a praying woman. The truth's a heavy burden and it's weighing on me. Red Dog has caught me slipping with the wailing on me. I went to calling out for Jesus like a reverend on me. Chopped it up to sin, took it on my chin. Gotta take some L's if you wanna win. They took a but then take a sin. I didn't even have no re-up I could re-up with. Had to rob another just to re-up. Pray to God it in his heart, he found forgiveness for me. It was nothing personal, it was just business for me. When I got on, I paid him back and told him it was ugly. I'd rather ask forgiveness like 100 times than be asking for permission in a beggar's line. Cause of who I been, check out how I tend to mine. I got a partner who don't eat no poke at dinner time. But let you act like you gon' ever hurt or injure mine. He have your woman, and that's my dinner time. I keep my eyes on glory, tell the devil get behind. Now bear in mind the devil made me offers I decline. We not aligned, not combined, I am not confined to any wicked system that these demons have designed. They frame a mind and have you salty as a bacon rind. I'm trying to mastermind how to help out humankind. I'm open mind, but I do not walk with none aligned. My state of mind is to keep a peace for peace of mind. I'm like Malcolm with my peace at the Venetian blinds. I'm trying to manifest the things in my subconscious mind that I have only seen in dreams in my unconscious mind. My dreams unrefined, swing the mind, a state of mind that make it seem this lucky life of mine is pre-designed. And if it is, then thank the Lord, cause that's the mastermind.
Yes, Lord. Yes, Lord. Yes, Lord.
Look, I played the game, I missed a shot. I had the answer, then forgot. I knew one day my pop finance, my not for lexing. I fell out and cut the check, my not paralyzed the set, but I been taking hits like I can die like innocent. Morning the day, the dawn of the dead day. I don't see nothing but red. I gather the blankets and milk and the bread. I come from the east and I'm traveling west. Got a machete, I chopping the nigga, the surfer, determined the plot and the threats. It ain't no stopping and run, popping son of God, dropping anybody who next. I want a mansion, I got a million.